The one that's prominent in the news is the COVID-19, and it is different than other ones because it's new, and we don't know everything about it just yet. Coronaviruses have been out there for a long time, and there's a variety of different versions. This COVID-19 is different in that it generally presents with a fever and a cough, whereas other viruses might have a runny nose, a sore throat, maybe general not feeling well, like the flu virus. The flu is a virus, influenza, where this COVID virus is a little bit different.
It's new, it's a brand new virus, and that's why there's no immunity in the world to this. And so that's why people are getting sick. They have no natural immunity. So educating students is the first thing we can do to keep them safe. If they're aware of things that could be a concern, we need to educate them on why it's a concern, and then what can they do to protect themselves, whether that's the hand washing on a daily basis frequently, not touching their faces, coughing into their elbow, not touching others, all of those things will help keep them safe.
Ideally, hand washing is always the best, but if you can't wash your hands, then you can use a hand sanitizer, but it should be at least 60% alcohol or higher. And it's the same, you still have to do the scrubbing and for at least 20 seconds to have it be effective. And the scrubbing does actually, the abrasiveness of it help with killing the germs.
Touching the things in your environment with unwashed hands and simply wiping your eye, or in kids' cases, picking their nose or putting their fingers in their mouth can introduce any virus into the body and could make a person sick.
So when you think about how many people in the course of a day touch a handrail or a doorknob, or you don't know who's sitting in the desk before you. So again, that lends to hand washing, how important it is when you're in a big group setting like we are at school, exposed to a lot of people.
If a child presents to the nurse's office with respiratory symptoms, stuffy nose, sore throat, and cough, I'm going to do an assessment, and then I decide, you know, are they well enough to remain in school, or do they need to go home? Is this time to go home? We deal with that on a daily basis as registered nurses in the DoDEA schools.
If their student has a fever and a cough, especially if that fever and cough is causing the child to have difficulty breathing, that would be an emergency room visit. If they have a fever and a cough that's new, it's also important to go see the doctor and make sure that they're being checked by a medical professional and getting the care that they need.
It's really important that adults and kids stay home when they are sick. Our guidelines for DoDEA is that you have to be without a fever, so 100 or above is what we consider a fever, and you cannot have diarrhea or vomiting for a full 24 hours before you return to school, and that is without medicine. Because if you take medicine, your fever will come down, but that doesn't mean that you aren't still sick with the virus or bacteria.
I think it's more about being prepared. DoDEA has had a pandemic response protocol policy in place for many years since the H1N1 flu came about. We received education and planning and preparation for that.
I've sent emails directly to the parents, the students, and our faculty, so we're all on the same page getting the same message. We also use the weekly newsletter with articles and web links that they can go to. We refer them to the DoDEA page specifically on the coronavirus. Some nurses are going into the classroom, especially with the little ones, and teaching hand washing. We did that in the fall. It's a good time to review that information.
The latest information is all posted on the Centers for Disease Control webpage, as well as the DoDEA webpage. And the DoDEA webpage, if you scroll down to the bottom, there are several links to a variety of military health resources, CDC resources, and other valid sites.